Cookie debut. That's right, Banana is finally here after all this time. Let's have a look at her. So, she's once again here with her little choco monkey. Savannah Lion Pet has stayed the same. Everything is pretty much more or less the same-ish. The skill has been reworked a little bit. We are still jumping through hoops, but first we have to collect the hoops. She still produces a lot of coins. Well, not like a lot of coins, but a decent amount. We'll be trying her as a coin farmer, potential coin farmer, a bit later. But for now, let's just have a look at her. Now, as we can see, because she's been released so late, she is a good scorer. We can already see that this is max level Cookie and max level Pet, but there is no candy on her yet. But we're still earning a really, really good score. So I would say because of the way she produces coins, and they are all super magnetic, like you do not even have to like run along and collect them. They will come to you. This will make the popping candy treasure, the one that the little album one that costs like 400 coins per go, an absolute must when using Banana Cookie. It will just be popping off. So the Savannah Pet fires a coin firework every so often. These coins are also super magnetic, and on the third one you get like a special big lion coin worth a few more coins and points. Now, as we could see there, when collecting a blast, the blast does not follow into the skill. It will follow up after the skill has ended. I think this is because the skill will be pretty difficult to achieve like perfectly under blast conditions, I reckon. So yeah, so blast is not applied to the skill. It will come up after any remaining blast. There's the big coin. So I would say, like, at the moment with no candy, I would say this score is pretty good. Now, because the pet does not produce any health or anything like that, you could potentially replace the Savannah Lion if you were going to use Banana in a high score run. However, due to it giving like a 1.5 million combi bonus, I really think that it's probably best to keep them together. And I will have a video coming up later of the 500 odd million run with the Banana Cookie and Savannah Lion as the starters. So it's like Banana is definitely worth it. So as we see, giant mode is available if you're going to be running in the skill, so that is perfectly okay. But 231 million for our first go, just max pet max Cookie. So the candy does throws a hula hoop forward, makes it come back and travel in obstacles. So jump over the returning hula hoop to earn points. This is key. So magic candy, I'm gonna say frozen bears or bonus coins. Now I went for both of them, I'm not too sure which, but yeah. So for this I'm gonna repeat the same map. I've got the coin bonus on right now, as I believe if you're gonna be running this map, then the frozen bear one really won't be much use. And with the amount of coins that Banana produces, I do think that having the plus 400 or whatever points you get for coins would be a pretty good idea. Now, there we saw when you jump over the hula hoop, you do have some invincibility, which means you do not have to worry about jumping into obstacles or jumping down a hole. Okay, it's not a massive long invincibility, it's just like a second or so, but it is excellent and it will help you a lot in the avoiding of the hula hoop, because it's like worth 4.5 million, I believe, and that is a lot of points to lose. And so I think they've done a really good job with that by giving you that invincibility. So it's not like, oh, that timing was really bad, because you can't control this hula hoop at all. It just comes when it comes. So you know what I mean? So the invincibility a little bit. Oh, here, I messed that up. I do not think I got the point because I mistimed the jump for the hula hoop and the giant and stuff like that. So yeah. If you've got in that kind of situation, then that's too bad. You've lost the points. But overall, I think most, like 90% of the time, the hula hoops are easily avoidable. And Yeah. They collect everything, though. They collect absolutely everything. Rainbow bears, any jelly, including health jellies. Now, this really surprised me, and we'll see it. Oh, I knocked it down there as well. So, yeah. Sometimes it is a little bit hard to avoid. And I think that is quite a unique kind of thing, because usually if something is thrown out by the cookie or a treasure, you want to collect it, such as the boomerang and stuff like that. But this time you want to avoid the hula hoop for whatever reason, considering in the skill we are collecting them. But there, you saw the hula hoop collects a potion. I think that's a really... It can be a bit of a game-breaking kind of ability that. Like, I do know, like, a lot of skills and stuff that used to collect potions, like any of the treasures as well. They actually disabled it in the end, but they've allowed it with banana. I wonder if they're going to change that, but yeah, for the moment, you can collect health potions with banana's mini candy skill. 269, I'm pretty happy with that. So... yeah, I think Banana's going to be top tier. Here are the relationships. Looks like a wolf I once met while exploring the world. Friendly with werewolf. The tiger I met in the jungle. Friendly with fig lily. I'll perform a circus trick worth all those coins. Friendly with cheesecake. Thanks for the magic card. Friendly with cinnamon. Just what a friendly person. I saw you sitting in the front row. Friendly with pudding. And she's always so honest and funny. Trust with... ice juggler. Yeah, well, there you go. All right, well, that is going to be it for this video. Until next time, bye-bye.